Hiya, I think there's dirt on the lens. I might look a bit rough, I've just got out of hospital. Had my coronary ablation, heart ablation, today's Thursday, Tuesday, it seems so long ago, Tuesday, between 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. Something in that window. Apparently they're setting up, you know, what everything they do takes a while, and anyway, that's how long I was in theatres. And got back to the ward and felt all right. And here's a couple of stories for you. One story is the nurses thought I was diabetic. Oh, we need to do your bloods, you're diabetic. I said, no, I'm not. So, well, someone told us you are. I said, well, I'm not. So there's a miscommunication today. And then one nurse said, well, why are you testing your blood glucose? I said, I've had a coronary heart attack in December caused by 11 plus years of carbs, including the Endura gels, including these Endura gels full of fructose, including the rehydration fluid, and it says, you know, 15 minutes before, and then every 30 minutes you can actually do it on cheese, which is what I've been trying to tell people. And so I went from quitting sugar in December to quitting carbs. I haven't fully completed quitting carbs, it's still ongoing process. Anyway, back to why I'm doing the video. I got these pliers online because the way the sticks are put in this, you're not supposed to touch the top. So it's like, well, how do you get the top out without touching it and then putting it in the machine? So I don't want to contaminate the strips. I want to make sure my blood glucose is as accurate as possible when I'm doing it. I'm aiming for fasting blood glucose of 4.4. I've seen a couple under 5. Today was 5.3, but because of the surgery and everything, my meal was late last night, and the pliers, see? And the other thing I want to say is, I had a bit of an episode, should we call it, in the hospital, and a person comes in to see me who shall remain nameless. And they said, now I've done 30 marathons, completed 30 marathons since 2008. I stopped in 15 because of my neck spinal cord stimulator issues and got married and, you know, marathon running went out the window. My fitness got worse. I was still running, but it was not getting any better, and had my heart attack. Then realised what destructive stuff I was doing by eating carbs and sugar. Oh, I've got to get the phone. So I forgot what I was up to now because the phone went. Anyway, so I said to, in the afternoon, this person was talking to me. We weren't meant for long distance running. We were meant to, you know, just come out of our caves and throw a spear and grab our animal. And this person is telling me this, and I've got the most tremendous migraine ever, your worst headache. She's telling me this, I'm listening, but my heart monitor is saying tachy because it's like over 100, and I'm trying to drink coffee because I can't wake up. And my mate's just come off the phone. She said, oh my God, you sound so much better than last night. This morning, 2 o'clock this morning, I felt a lot better. And then I started looking up Homo erectus and Neanderthal. And I thought, So when my physician came in this morning, I said to him, he knows we speak candidly. I said to him, Homo erectus and Neanderthal man would not have had spears, and so they would have chased down their prey and kept, you know, chasing until they did get their prey, wouldn't they? So, which means they can run for hours and hours not come out of a cave with a spear and spear, you know, I said, animals aren't going to be like that. They've got to go and hunt for them. And I said, so this woman said, don't do long distance running, change your sport. And because you could be scarring your heart. And he turned around and he says, she's absolutely wrong, because there's two or three athletes, top athletes, who have done real serious intensive endurance training and they've scarred their hearts. But for everyone else, he said, running is fine, and the running you do is fine, and carry on, and I would never tell you to stop it. So, yeah, to be in a cardiac unit and this woman is, she's telling me this story and it's like, well, why are you telling me? Because there's fucking hundreds, thousands, millions of us running. And it's like, yeah, we're not all dropping down heart attacks because of endurance running. We're talking, yeah, I personally believe my heart attack was brought down by insulin resistance, too much sugar and carbs over a 10, 11 year period sustained, which led to arteriosclerosis, which led to the artery blocking, but it didn't block. I then got a spasm, which I believe was caused by overloading of sugar, fructose on the mitochondria. That brought about the heart attack, which took me to the hospital, and then they transferred me, and the rest is history because I had my stent. So I'm carrying on the road of absolutely no sugar and quitting carbs. And yeah, I've still lost eight point something kg. Started the journey at 92.8 and I'm 84 something today. But today's not a good day to measure it anyway. Would love to hear your stories. So if you can share any, flick us a message. I always respond to my comments. Talk to you soon. Cheers. Bye.